Okay, now we are going to see the assessment. Of course, as you know, we have two types. We have the formative assessment and then the summative assessment. Now, the formative assessment, this is of course, it has been defined by many scholars, and the different scholars have different definitions. But for easy understanding of what formative assessment is, this is evaluation of students' learning progress, and it's done throughout the course. So this is done when someone is learning, in the learning period is learning, say in senior one, in senior two, in term one, like that. That's what they call, you give assessments in form of tests. You can give a quiz, you can be in a class and then you give a quiz, you give some exercises. So that's what they call formative assessment as learning is going on. Now this assessment in the listening curriculum is going to take 20%. So out of the 4 years, you are going to be assessing these kids at the end of every chapter, as I am going to take you through after these assessments. I'm going to show you that how is that it's going to be done. But after all those assessments, they are going to take 20%. Now, what about the summative? Now the summative is what we are going to do at the end of the learning period. You know, someone in secondary here is supposed to learn from senior one up to senior four. So by the end of that learning process, after the 4 years, then it's going to do we are going to do what we call a summative assessment. And that summative assessment is going to be taking 80%. And when you get this 80 plus this 20, the student will be having his or her 100%. Now, this assessment here, okay, anyway, I will show you how we are going to do this. This is, then let us see what assessment is. In simple terms, summative is going to be at the end of the 4 years. Then summative, we are going to do it when the student is still in these 4 years. Senior one, we assess. Senior two, we assess. In senior one, first term, we assess. Second term, we assess. But you are assessing according to the topics or the chapters you are having. In simple terms, based on the activities of integrations, as we are going to see there. Anyway, let us see assessment. This is a measure of the extent to which established learning outcomes have been attained by learners. Forms of assessment. Now, these are the forms we are going to base on. We are going to be able to call the assessment for learning, assessment of learning, and assessment as learning. But we are going to focus on this first assessment for learning, then you are going to also handle the other last two. This is formative and continuous. I think we know what we mean by formative. Throughout the learning process, it involves both the teacher and the learner. A teacher uses information about student skills, knowledge, understanding to give them feedback on how to improve. Students should understand what they are to learn and what's expected of them. Now, this one now is the process of now. Okay, let us first see if I go deep into this. How do we use the assessment of learning? Now, in assessment for learning, we are going to form smaller groups. Assign tasks to learners in bid to make them more active. Give audience to small groups to present their findings and to make them more independent. Guiding the smaller groups on what to learn and the breadth of their findings. Now, here, what we are going to do here, you are going to, of course, people have applied this, but we are going to group these students in groups. At least, not too small, but not too big. At least, small groups, at least from between 5 to 10 students. You can't form a group of 20, because that one is going to be disorganized, I'm telling you. But between 5 to, depending on the number of students we have in the class, so between 5 to 10, you can make those groups. Then you give them tasks to handle. But now here, as a teacher, in assessment for learning, you go in those small groups, and then as you guide them on what to do. But students should know what to do. And then, you after seeing what they are doing in a group, then you give them a feedback in their small groups. So here we are doing this assessment for learning. We are doing it in these groups. You move from this group you observe what is happening first, then you intervene, and then you are just guiding. But when they are still in their smaller groups, so move from one group to another. Of course, they know what they are going to do. Now you move as you are guiding them. You move to this group, you move to this group, you move to this group, in simple terms. Just simple moving, and then as you are guiding them. Simple, that's what we do in assessment for learning. How do you know that you have, of course you see, as they are doing the activity or the task you are giving them, you can say this one, this is the knowledge they are having, these are the skills they are applying. Then you as a teacher, you say, what if this, what if you do it in this way? If you guide them, don't give them answers directly, no. You give them proactive questions, okay? How do you sort of do this? How do you sort of do this? How can you, why don't you? Okay? As simple as that. But for learning, some assessment for learning, you basically move from one group to another as you guide them. When they are doing their work, but for you, you come in to guide them. We are going to see now, after this, you're going to see assessment as learning. I mean assessment of learning, but please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can easily change the qualities of the video depending. You click on the video, 3 dots there up. Then after you go to advanced setting, then you go to the videos, the quality you want, you choose there. There will be 360, 480, 720. Then you choose the quality you want. See you in the next lesson.